because my glasses are always sliding down. Yeah. Well, hi, fans. Welcome to the CRUMB Comic Show. And it's really great to be here tonight. Yeah. Why do I bother?
But you love it.
Well, now we're going to do a song for you. It's called Mysterious Moes, and we hope you like it.
Roaming through this land, far and near you'll hear him, he is found on every hand. Why, every city, town, and village knows this boy by now. There's a way to recognize him, let me tell you how. If your path at midnight dark beside a graveyard goes, if someone puts up that mysterious pose, you're on some dark and stormy night while the tempest blows. If someone puts out that mysterious pose, he sees all, knows all, gets in everywhere. Some night he might wait for you up on the stairs. So if you're going down the cellar, walk up on your toes. If someone puts out that mysterious pose.
Unhampered by the grim realities of economic necessity. What I really need is a rich girlfriend. No, in a situation like that, well, I just feel stifled. You know, it's funny, but, well, I'm not as free as I once thought myself to be when I wrote in another sketchbook, I'm a free man. Well, since then, I've come to feel a burden of financial obligations and commitments weighing heavily on me. Mostly the money I'm supposed to pay my former spouse and the huge tax debt left over from the lush times of the past. I don't want to do a regular strip for The Voice anymore. The hell with it. And I hate the idea of having to do it for the money. The hell with the money. I don't want to be a responsible adult. I can't stand it. It's torture. I gotta keep my life open. I can only think of the bleak life my father got trapped in. Well, I'm sorry, but I won't let it happen to me. Does this mean that I'm a bump? My father's worst fear. Well, once as a small child, I saw my father break down and cry because my mother called him a bump.
Oh, everybody!
Tragedy suddenly hits Bob like a bolt of lightning.
Well, the crumbs on the hair raise my chair. Something like that. Oh, God.
Get a grip on yourself, Bob. Discipline your inner self. Practice yoga, concentration, meditation. Straighten up that spine.
Well, I'm too lazy and self-indulgent for that. It's hard enough just to get up in the morning.
You better take the bull by the horns, or life is gonna break you. You'll end up another tragic case like most people when they're old.
But I can't do it. It's too hard.
Okay, just forget it. Forget I said anything. Do what you want.
Oh, no, wait. I don't know. Is there ever really any way to win? You don't see many living examples. It must be as rare as Black Patty records. Many are called, but few are chosen.
Well, Bob's all in the dinner now.
According to the personal obsessions of our crew.
Hey! Choice of ethnic group. Jewish, Japanese, Hawaiian, Samoan, Scandinavian, German, Anglo-Saxon, Irish, Russian, Polish, American mixed, Mexican, Indian, Chinese, Negro. Height unimportant, but preferably tall. Skin unimportant. Hair, unimportant. Full lips. Big teeth. Strong, straight back. Strong neck and shoulders, firm breasts. Size, unimportant. Strong, straight arms, fairly small in the waist. Full round belly, exaggerated forward pelvic thrust. Large thighs, large muscular legs in general. Thick ankles, large, wide, strong feet. Last, but not least, exceptionally large, well-endowed, but firm buttocks with shelf effect.
What dismal fate awaits this silly fellow? Hopeless, just hopeless.
Hopeless and utterly helpless.
What a fine rear shelf that gal has. That'd be the best piggyback ride of my life. Oh, he's built from the ground up. Just look at those ankles, those legs, those feet. Riding on the seat of learning. I may be woefully out of step in many ways, but still, the main source of inspiration for me is when I'm high atop that pulsating, throbbing, powerful life form and most highly evolved animal organism. Well, now, this may be a waste of my talent, and it may go against a lot of forces which are strong in current social behavior, but I can't help myself. Maybe I'm too much controlled by the sexual part of myself. I don't know. Maybe I'm morally bankrupt. Maybe I'm just a victim of my time. I don't know. Doesn't seem to be much I can do about it. Well, I know many people, especially women, who despise my attitude, my sense of humor, my whole basic essence, but I can't help it. Well, there she is. The faceless, prostrate female. What is she thinking? Well, many probably hate this position while others love it. Naturally, I gravitate towards the ones who enjoy it. Enough said. Well, everybody thinks they're superior to everybody else in some way, but I really am. Girls always think I'm funny looking. They're just stupid and small-minded. Little mindless conformists. What are they? Well, all they want in history is a great artist long after they're dead.
Filled with hatred. Suddenly, a talking bird appears in front of you.
Robert! You mustn't harbor poisonous bitterness in your heart. Remember, you too were once as foolish as those innocents for shame.
Yeah, but I rose above it. I became thoughtful and compassionate. I'm kind. Oh, you're right. I'm still as foolish as those girls for not realizing it was only some fortunate twist of fate which allowed me to escape the social restrictions which bind most people's lives. And I'm such an egotist. I resent them for their conditions. It's beyond their control. My reaction to them makes me one and the same as them.
No better and no worse, so come off it.
You are so-called artist doesn't know how good he has it. He should only have to trade places for one day with a Malaysian farm worker. So what if he finds her?
Oh, let's face it, I hate work. I just want to play and have a good time. Such torture. Wish I was done with this already. Is it time for lunch yet? Not that I don't take pride in my work. I mean, hey, I love the finished product. Getting there, it's a hard part. Why is it such a difficult process? I mean, what makes drawing these comics such arduous labor? So self-conscious and uptight. It used to be easier, but, well, those days are gone forever. Ah, yes, those lighthearted, carefree days of my foolish youth back in the 60s. Oh, I was funnier then. Now I'm washed up. I gotta quit this business. This new stuff is not funny. And plus, the pressure is unbelievable. Your stuff in the 60s was the greatest.
Why don't you do good work anymore?
Oh, nobody understands.
Why should they?
What about you doing the cause of social injustice?
Racist!
I can't take it. For one thing, I'm far too intimidated by the fans, by the great expectations of the audience.
No more, Mr. Natural!
Sometimes I think it's a natural reaction anyone has to achieve a certain degree of fame and adulation through the various forms of mass media. Well, no wonder it's so hard to face the drawing board. Sheesh!
A certain kind of self-consciousness sets in. There's a loss of innocence. The person starts trying to live up to the image the audience has of him. Takes on a heaviness. There's a lack of the flair of quality that was in the earlier pre-fame work. Technical progress, yeah, but that certain magic!
Oh, I gotta quit this business. It's no good. I'm through.
You can't. No, Bob, you're in this thing too late. And anyway, you love it.
No, I don't.
You love every minute of it. Let's face it. You don't want to hung yourself off as a big martyr. Your main problem is you've got to get your act together. Straighten up and fly right. Learn to stay away from cocktail parties and out of that pound, eh? Learn to say no to the sharpies. And get control.
Help me! Oh, now I know why people kill. How much can a human spirit take?
Oh, no.
It's the fact that that horrible feeling has returned.
Self-pity overtakes the poor devil. The uncertainty, the confusion.
Yeah, not to mention this horrible headache that won't go away. Let's face it, my will's too weak. It's not strong enough to withstand this unrelenting marathon called life. Humans are not that different from chickens. And I'm confused and overwhelmed. I don't know what's going on in the world.
Cut the pretensions, Bob, and remember, you are just a cartoonist. Accept your limitations, and above all, don't forget, cessation of desire. It's all illusion, Bob. All those things you think you want and need, it's all in your mind, buddy boy. Get control of your mind, and you'll find you don't need any of it. You'll find life simpler, cleaner when you get a grip on your primal urges. Oh, but it's too hard, isn't it? You are so human. The pleasures of the flesh bring you such joy, such ecstasy. You're inclined to think it's worth the price sometime. The price of the agony, the suffering, the confusion your desires put you through. Maybe as time marches on and you get older and more experienced, you'll see more and more clearly the folly of all this chasing around after sensual addiction. How nowhere these paths lead. What else is there, you ask? Whimpering and sobbing in helplessness, quivering chaos and confusion. Yes. What else is there? One.
Mastery of self.
Two.
Mastery over desire.
Three.
Transcendence of the illusion of the senses.
Four.
Utilizing your energy for a larger cause, socialism.
Five.
Peace of mind and body, a sense of harmony with nature.
Six.
Greater satisfaction.
Seven.
Real strength of character.
Bob, you're not listening to me, Bob. You're a fool, Bob.
I make myself sick.
Next day.
Oh, I can't think of anything to draw.
Don't think, Bob. Just draw.
Hey, now this works. Yeah, all I have to do is start in and get the pen moving and things start happening on the paper. Yeah, this is great. It's kind of like a Zen meditation practice, an exercise in spontaneous creativity. Well, I must remember this and never get hung up about drawing again, right?
Yeah, sure.
The trouble with me is I'm lazy. I don't want to do anything that's hard or technically challenging. I just want to draw stuff that's easy. The hardest thing to do is the copy from real life. The easiest thing to do is just draw myself sitting around. Now the question is it artistically and spiritually better to do what's easy or to struggle with difficult projects? I mean, a technical skill does not a great artist make. But on the other hand, I don't know.
Mr. Natural, what should I do?
Go forth and pick me 2 bushels of shoes.
Make shoes?
Yes, find me an orchard of shoe trees.
I'm certainly glad somebody gets a kick out of my tortured soul. I think I'm gonna go home and cry myself to sleep.
Say, listen, I thought you were supposed to be one of those spiritual teachers.
I am, you dick knucklehead. Oh, you have little faith. Why don't you do as I told you?
But,
go!
He was right, as usual.
Hey, give us a scam, baby.
Chuck you, Barley.
Oh, come on, hey, let's rat.
Oh, I don't feel like it.
What's the matter, boss?
Oh, I don't know. It's not something I can talk about, really.
Your gal run out on you?
No, no, nothing like that.
Hey, you down on your luck? Hey, I know what that's like, man. Here, let me help you out. I mean, as a buddy.
No, I don't need any money.
You sure? I got extra.
Oh, that's all right. I have enough. More than enough.
Say, listen, I never seen the like. Your gal give you the clap? You need a fix, man? A drink?
Look, I can't explain it. It has something to do with a sense of cosmic despair.
Huh? Oh, my. White folks sure is crazy.
I want to kiss a boy. Help me!
Oh, good Lord! My fantasies are getting the best of me!
The
me.
It's all too beautiful.
It's just like in that song where Gene Pitney says, only love can break a heart.
Miserable souls forever tormented.
Pray, my boy, pray!
Pray? Huh? To whom? To what? Are you serious?
Now that's a silly question. Unless you can pray, your state of being will remain as it is.
Is that so? Is that a fact?
That is indeed a fact, fool!
Okay, if you say so, here goes. Please, God, or whoever you are, give me a sign, like, make it rain tears.
When will they learn?
Hey, you going in the north? Yep. No. No, north, no. Yeah, I know! Yeah, you know. Enough, okay, you shut your yap! Boy, nothing doing. You wanna watch it, knuckle nose? Not you, I don't love with you, not! With me, you'll never when I nibble your noggin with my mitts, mug! Yeah, you and your head, yeah, do
give me the answer right now. You simply must.
Must I?
Yes, you must.
Oh, let's see. I put it in my pocket about a week ago.
If I remember correctly.
Let's see. Oh, yeah. Here it is, my boy.
Oh, thank you. But this is written in some odd language.
Oh, yes. That's a long, extinct Eastern tongue.
Can you read it to me?
I'm afraid not, no. I don't have no idea how to decipher it.
So, if I can find out what this little piece of paper says, I'll know the truth, right?
Precisely, Flaky Flute.
There's nobody left that knows this language?
It's correct. The last guy died a couple years ago.
Then how in the hell am I supposed to?
There's only one thing you can do. If you want to know what it says, you'll have to figure it out for yourself.
But that can take forever.
Maybe. Maybe not. You seem to be a man of intelligence.
Well, why haven't you worked it out yet, Mr. Know-It-All?
Actually, I have.
You have? Then goddammit, tell me what it says!
It's untranslatable!
Keep your sunny side out. Hide your sword against gloom. If you have nine sons in a row, start a baseball team.
Tell me what sort of twisted, perverted drawings I'll come up with today. And you know,
folks. There's only one country in the world where a person can get away with expressing themselves as freely as I do, and that's right here in the good old USA, and don't you forget it. So when I tear down this country and criticize our society, well, remember that I do it with love. If I didn't love it, I'd leave it. Only I ain't leaving. It's my country, right or wrong, and I know it's my duty in life to help right the wrongs in the land of my people, the good old U.S. of A.
This land is your land. This land is my land. From California to New York Island.
But just to prove my point, let me dig into my fabulous record collection here. Most of you youngsters out there are totally unaware of our rich musical heritage here in America. I mean America. Yeah. We Dog Waltz by Joe Foster's Hungry Sandlappers, an old string band of the 20s.
And his tail cut off.
About being so attached to mere material objects. As long as those records are in here, I'll never attain higher consciousness. But it's a sickness, really. And let's face it, it's more than just a love of music. It's collecting mania, the thrill of possession, the owning of a fetish, the mysterious attraction of the Ceres syndrome. So what? A guy's entitled to a hobby, you might say, but where does hobby leave off and anal obsession take over? Wisest thing to do would be get rid of the whole damn collection. And if I start thinking about that very much, I get real sad. I mean, well, how can I ever part with my copy of Happy Days and Lonely Nights by Charlie Fry and his $1 million pier orchestra? Well, I know if I did get rid of them, I'd feel 2,000 pounds lighter.
Anal retentives have trouble letting go of things. Let's face it, this is neurotic behavior.
I must do some serious thinking about this whole business. Jesus. Well, shit. Well, fuck them, Doc Bonham. Christ. Oh, shoot. I'm just full of meanness.
He's bristling with hostility.
God, how I hate people. I loathe every person I see on the street. And I want to kill some of these.
This cartooning is tricky business.
Hey, what goes on here?
Hi, folks.
Out of the bag, he's bad.
Well, you're not supposed to.
Step aside, sucker. I'm taking over here. I'm the best character this dopey jerk ever invented. That's why this comic is going to be all devoted to the great me. It'll contain all stories of me doing anything I want. They love me out there, I know it.
Oh, I'll get back in your place, you little.
Ah, you shut up. Oh. And you aren't listening to any more of his tiresome ruminations either. Here I am. It's nothing but lots of laughs and thrills as you follow the clever and amusing antics of that irresistibly cute devil, me, on with the show.
The snoid goes bohemian. Not only did have that touch of madness that marks the true artist and breaks the hearts of the young girls from mine homes. Action painting. Woo!
Do you know who first said that, Beverly?
Snoid's college co-ed girlfriend, Beverly Bombstein.
Seth Ward, I'm sorry, I wasn't listening.
Wasn't listening.
Seth Ward, my darling.
Aye, the reason I wasn't listening was because I was deeply involved in practicing an intricate series of moments for a new sketch my band's purposely working on. It's entitled Self-Expression and the Human Condition. Well, of course, I'll show you how it goes. Like this.
Thank you. for this painting. I am deeply inspired by your essence. Please, I beg you. Just think of it. Someday in some great museum, a portrait of you, Beverly Bobstein, an ordinary little nobody, elevated to immortality by the brushstrokes of a star.
Okay, I'll do it. How do you want me to go?
Self-discipline. I'm always vacillating this way and that.
work on that. Or should I? I mean, hey, this flabbiness of will is good in some ways. It's a certain looseness which lends itself well to the kind of work I do, allowing nutty ideas, quirky notions, and kinky funny stuff to spill out onto the paper. At the same time, it also causes chaos, confusion, and an aimlessness which causes me to be victimized by the slightest outside influence or adverse circumstance. Oh, well, what are you gonna do, huh?
7 foot Amazon, it's radio!
I'll tell you when cross, hope you won't feel hurt behind.
I swear. best. I'd just soon stay in bed if it's all the same to you. I don't care if I never get up.
Oh, what's wrong with you? Are you constipated? What?
Ah, I tossed and turned all night long. I couldn't get to sleep after looking through this delightful little tome that came in the mail yesterday.
Are crumb checklist? Boy, what the hell is this?
It's a list of every work of mine that's ever been printed anywhere. Plus a long, detailed account of my personal life up to now, and it is meticulously cross-referenced to the point of compulsiveness. The guy who put this together must be nuts.
And why do you get selling? They must really think you're hot stuff to do something like this on you and your work. Why would you lie and be flattered?
I'm flattered.
Duty!
But at the same time, I mean, a thing like this is guaranteed to make someone like me so acutely self-conscious I'll never draw another cartoon as long as I live.
Quit your whining. A thing like this should inspire you into greater heights of artistic accomplishment.
Oh, it's incapacitating, you kid. I'll never draw another cartoon again, I know it. I can't even imagine facing the drawing board. I'm through, finished, washed up.
Well, that's just fine. Who's gonna take care of this now?
Listen, Arlene, why are you trying to make me feel guilty about this, huh? Did I make you feel guilty when you start getting therapy for your drinking problem? No.
Well, you can just take your walk with self-pity. I have lots of things to do.
Self-pity, huh? Ah, she's right. Well, that's always been one of my favorite pastimes. And now I'm getting old, something else I feel sorry for myself about. Well, I can practically feel death creeping up on me. Slowly, slowly, the cold, clammy hand is almost on me. The idea of death is not so frightening anymore as it is disgusting. The stench, the rottenness, the decay, ugh. God, and I'm totally prostrated. I'm flattened. I mean, I don't have the will or the energy to do anything. The idea of getting out of bed and facing the world makes me feel sick, nauseous. It's not just this silly little book either. I mean, it's an accumulation of a lot of things, thousands of things. It's like the whole direction of my life has brought me up to this point. Now it all somehow seems, I don't know. I have no idea what I should do now. I mean, I know there's lots of things that need to get done. Clean the chimney and so forth. Fuck that shit, it can wait. Shit. I never thought I'd see the day where I'd be going through something as silly and mundane as midlife crisis. God, how bourgeois. This is it, all right. It's been building up for a long time. In fact, it's only sheer momentum that's kept me going for about the past 5 years. God, I used to be so cocksure of what I wanted. I had contempt for those people who seemed lost, aimless, without direction. I thought, ha! Well, they just have it too easy. That's their trouble. Me, I've had to struggle to get where I am. I've been through the school of hard knocks. I know the score. Now here I am, just another lost soul at the age of 39. Well, success has had a lot to do with it. Yeah, I mean, I've arrived. I'm a well-known artist. I got a nice wife, a nice kid, nice place to work, friends. I'm socially accepted. I get invited to lots of parties, everything. Hope I don't blow it all on some quirky little malcontented whim of the moment. Human nature is like that. So why am I having a crisis? What's wrong with me? Well, on the surface, everything appears to be fine. I mean, couldn't be better. Who has a better life than me, huh? Nobody. Who has it easier, softer than me? Well, I can't think of a living soul I'd trade places with. Well, that's just it. I've got it too easy. I've gone soft. I don't have to struggle anymore. Everything's too easy. It used to be different. I mean, I used to be tough. I was motivated by fear. Now all I want is fun, fun, fun. That's my trouble. Yeah, I created my own sweet little world around myself, and now here I sit. I'm in a vacuum. My own little ivory tower. Yeah, I've got a number on myself, all right? I'm a smart cookie, yeah. I got a piss and I'm hungry. I guess I'll get up.
Well, Doc, did you decide to get up and face the world? It was a tough world out there.
Yeah, I was getting hungry. Well, what's for breakfast?
It's lunchtime already. I made egg salad. It's in the fridge. Hot pie!
You going to town today, Arlene?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I'll go with you. I got to do some errands.
Well, for heaven's sake, get cleaned up. I don't
my mom. Well, it's a beautiful day here as usual. Gosh, this town is so utopian, it's truly amazing. No poor people, no crime, no angry-looking Negroes, no third-world oppressed. Well, you'd think this was heaven if you just got off the boat here. I mean, it's all so boring, though. I mean, its lovely tree-lined streets are intensely irritating. I guess I should be grateful to live in such a nice place. Oh, I gotta sit down. I feel weak. I wonder if I'm physically ill. Or maybe I'm getting some kind of chronic condition. Oh, no, it's all in the mind, obviously. All we are some such foolishness. God, I am nothing if not a perfect fool. Hey, well, I know maybe I should try calling up some of the crazy girls I know in this town. Maybe that'll pull me out of this slump. It might be more trouble than it's worth. I mean, God, women are such aggravation. She works at Kinko's Copies. Dear Jesus, what a spectacular rump she's got. What I really should do if I want to pull myself together is go sit in the park and meditate for an hour. Yeah, I know that'd help a great deal. Well, meditation really works. I used to do it a few years ago, and it really did improve my mental state. I did it every morning for about a year. It's amazing to think of that now. Where'd my self-discipline go? Oh, I remember now, I stopped after the baby came. Yeah, I really should make an effort to start meditating again. I mean, the trick is if you can force yourself to sit down, take the time out, do absolutely nothing for a half hour a day. It's not as easy as it sounds. I know, I've tried shit. My mind's always frantically searching for some distraction, and it usually has no trouble in finding them either. Don't I know it? Fitness is the thing at the university here. Who was it that said, Lord, deliver me from sickly women and healthy men? Well, I'll buy that. Hey, I know. I guess I'll try calling up that crazy Frankie. She's an amazing specimen herself. I hope she's around and up for a little visit. Ooh, those ankles, those feet. Hello, Frankie. Yeah, look, I thought I'd come over if you're not doing anything and make that drawing of you like I promised months ago.
Oh, yeah? Oh, goody, yeah, that might be fun. I've never posed for a real artist before.
Oh, okay, well, I'll see you in a little while.
A half hour later. Oh, he's really a neat guy. You like him. He's from Arizona and he's a genius. He's a nuclear physicist and... Guess what? He promised to take me with him on his next trip to the Himalayas. Ah, isn't that exciting?
Yeah, sounds like a total jerk, but what do I know? Let's see if we can't make this pose more unique.
Okay, how do you want me to be? Tell me.
I don't know. Let me think. I know. Can you bend over like this? Yay, Frankie, you are amazing! The things you can do with your body, I'm impressed! Oh, no, you're perfect! And I want to use your incredible body for a playground! Well, I gotta run now, Frankie. Sorry I didn't get to finish that drawing. I'll call you again sometime. Soon, hopefully.
Next morning.
What's this about a midlife crisis?
Oh, are you kidding? What a joke. I mean, hey, every
everything's coming up roses. Are you kidding? I mean, kid's first birthday, places coming together. Yeah, everything's coming up roses.
Hey, pal, a midlife crisis, don't you? I don't know. Don't worry, that lasts for 4 or 5 years.
Well, what would you do about it?
I don't know what to say about it. Got the midlife crisis. Got the midlife crisis. Certainly is wrecked me. There's nothing to do about it. You just have to wait it out. What's this here you're working on?
Oh, I'm trying to fix this lamp switch. It's a tricky little goddamn thing. There's this tiny piece of metal. I can't figure out how it fits in here.
You know, you can buy another one of those at the hardware store for a buck and a half. You're not that poor.
I know, I know. I just got obsessed with trying to figure out how to put this stupid thing back together. It's work avoidance, basically, is what it is. I mean, well, I should be in here working on comics, but I'm stymied by acute self-consciousness. I'm all froze up about drawing.
Man, you got it, man.
Yeah, it's all ego, 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 because I think I'm so great and all that. I've reached a point where it's impossible for me to live up to my own self-image. It's too hard to be a great artist. Why can't I just relax and forget about it?
Yeah. Success can get weird things in your karma. I used to run a music store in Santa Fe. It was a very successful business, a very prestigious establishment. I had to get out of it. One day I flipped everything. Now I got a wife, 10 kids, no career. They warned me.
Well, they say life begins at 40.
Did you ever hear of older guys that like to run off younger girls? Not like guys that are in their 50s or 60s that ditches their wives and takes up with a 20-year-old chick. You ever think about that?
Sure, you can. A young sweetie like that can do wonders for your ego. I can see why any guy did that if he had the chance.
Oh, if you can impress her on any young chick for an age like that.
Yeah. Now, it's funny how you play your struggling stride for years to get yourself into a nice, cute little setup like I've got here, and then...
Yeah, you think, well, this is what I wanted all along, yes, to do. A nice family, a nice place, a place to work.
Yeah, this is the moment when you can really blow it bad. I can see that.
Well, that's why I say the wisest things probably do nothing. Wait it out. It'll pass.
Well, if I can just figure out what to do with the rest of my fucking life. My wife's not too sympathetic either. I mean, God, she doesn't like me when I show weakness, uncertainty. She gets real annoyed and irritated and acts real bitchy all the time.
Of course, women are different. They operate on a different clock. They go through their crisis once a month. Hey, man, can I work some scrap wood?
Oh, yeah, I'll take all you want. I'll help you load it up here.
Oh, thanks, man. We're building a shed behind the trailer. Yeah. They don't fill up your ego anymore after they have kids. They change after they have kids.
Yeah, that's never the same. I mean, God, Arlene has really changed since she's had the soap. Now she's a mom. She doesn't pay as much attention to me anymore. Except to hand me a dirty diaper to rinse out the toilet.
Yeah. Those young girls start to look inviting. And you know, you can charm the pants off of them, too. It'd be so much easier than when you're a young pup with no experience.
Yeah, I don't know if I can do it, though. I mean, God, leave your family in the lurch just for your own little ego gratification? I don't know. A lot of guys do it, though. I can see an occasional little affair, maybe, but I don't know.
That's the trouble. You're at this point in your life where pursuing you more male ego satisfaction is foolish and selfish. So you can't do that either.
Well, then what can you do?
I don't know. Nothing. Wait it out.
What's so amusing on the radio, dearest darling?
This woman's talk on the sex therapist talk show. She's telling all about her husband's sexual inadequacies. His penis is too small and he can't get it up, and on and on and on.
Oh, man, I guess his life is ruined, huh?
Speaking of ruined lives, how's your midlife crisis coming, Bob?
Well, I discussed it with Bellcamp today. He said, don't worry about it. It only lasts 4 or 5 years. I guess it's not an uncommon thing for men at this age.
I'm sure. You gonna trade me another mirror model to be nicer to you than I am?
Well, that seems like the obvious despicable thing for the man to do, doesn't it? Are you worried about it?
Oh, I always had to expect you to run off with a younger girl sooner or later. In a way, it'd be preferable to watching you shuffle around here with a hangdog expression on your face for the next 5 years.
Do I have a hangdog expression on my face? God, I guess I do.
Yeah, you're moody and withdrawn. You don't put forth much in the way of positive energy. You're grumpy and you complain about everything.
God, that sounds horrible. Well, maybe I should move into a cheap hotel in downtown Sacramento and live by myself for a while.
Oh, don't sweat it, Bob. We get along. You're not nearly as obnoxious as my first husband. I don't expect perfect romance every day. I've got my job to do, taking care of the soul.
Yeah, and I got my job to do, only I'm not doing it. Soon our bank account will be down to a handful of change. Then what's going to become of us?
Well, we could always sell your record collection. That'll keep us going for a while. Then I could get a job and you can stay home and take care of the soap, I guess.
Oh, it's ridiculous. Well, I'll just get commercial art jobs, even though, God, I hate doing that stuff. But I'm sick of comics anyway. Well, how about if I take up a fine art career? Oil painting, maybe.
Yeah. Are you talking to me, Bob? There's sex there at the Sizzle Stream.
Well, suicide is out of the question. Running away is out of the question. Still, I gotta do something. My head's about to burst. What if a real crisis happened? I mean, nuclear holocaust, serious health problems. Not anything is possible. Well, here I've spent the last 10 years of my life clearing the way so I can do whatever I want to, and now that I got the chance, the golden opportunity that few men ever get, well, now I just sit here and throw up my hands.
Her husband's got performance anxiety.
Well, that's what I've got, performance anxiety. Yeah, I'm gonna go to that studio tomorrow and I'm gonna get to work. Nothing's gonna stop me, so help me God. And consider this, time is running out. Soon I'll be dead. Hey, look, Arlene, I finally gotten back to work. I'm doing this strip about my midlife crisis. What do you think, huh?
Dang, it's awful! You gotta make me look good or I'll cry!
And so, Uncle Bob's heroic struggle goes on!
Well, hi, folks. I fixed my toilet yesterday. It works real good now, and what's the use? I don't have anything to say. Hell, it's hard to get up here and just. Well, I know. I'll sing a song. I think that I shall never see a form as lovely as a tree. A tree whose hungry mouth is pressed against the earth's sweet glowing breast. A tree that looks at God all day and lifts her leafy arms to pray. A tree in summer that may wear a nest of robins in her hair, upon whose bosom snow has lain, who intimately lives with rain. Poems are made by fools like me, but only God can make a tree.
Thank you.